shake.
Get the fuck off my phone.
Is this not even that simple?
My name not Draco, it's Kennedy, last name Drake.
Hey, why the fuck I got a tomato with no lettuce though?
Hey, I'm about to show y'all how I got the wig from looking like this. Tutti. Tutti. First, I started by putting some shimmer lights in the sink with some hot water. Let me tell y'all something. I don't know what to do with no shimmer lights. All I know is to say blonde, you feel me? I just thought I was doing something for the day. Got the water out because I seen some of the color coming out. I just took it, gave it a nice little wash. The goal is really to get as much pink dye out as I could. I know I wasn't probably going to be able to get it all out in a certain amount of time. Like, let's do it. It was getting so nappy. I'm just like, let me just bathe it in some conditioner real quick because I needed to get a little detangled. When that was going on, I went ahead and put her cap on, but she been growing out these braids for 5 damn months. But I ain't gonna say nothing. That's my cousin. I ain't gonna DTM. Nah, I quit. But you know, she's just trying to let them grow out type shit. I'm like, damn, these edges thick as hell. I gotta put a band around that bitch. So boom, put a band around it. But really ain't DTM. So I put some oil in it. You feel me? Then I'm like, let me braid this kitchen, cause that you feel me? That kitchen was a. So you feel me? I went ahead and gunked some more gel on it because during this time, we didn't have no blow dryer, so I'm like, you feel me? I gotta do something, you feel me? So I went ahead and put the cap on with some gel and a little bit of boho, got to be glue spray, just hella different shit so it could dry out. So I went to go check on the hair, you feel me? It was looking all right. I went to go dump the water out, put it on the stove again, you feel me? Just do that. We ain't had no blow dryer, like I said, you know, so we got the fan, you feel me? So let me just give y'all a real tutorial instead of just yapping my mouth. So boom, first off, main goal with the wig cap is to get it as flat to your head and as close to the color of your head as possible so it imitates your scalp type stuff. You feel me? That's what I was doing right there. So we went back to the wig. And that shimmer light stuff just really did give it a different color. Now, wait a minute. Like, I ain't even have to clown on the effects like that. When it come to that recording, that them camera skills, I be on it. So long story short, the hair was getting lighter. I dumped the water out. You feel me? And then I'm like, let's go ahead and start giving it another hand wash. So I did that. I think this time I did it with some Danja soapy. I did that, got a little more of the color out and yada yada yada. And I'm like, I feel like it need one more round. It had gotten real bright at this point. I'm like, you feel me? Went back to drying her hair, but after I had put it in the water about one good more time, I think I conditioned it. Yeah, I conditioned it, combed it out. So you really want to take your time with combing out a wig, especially someone else's wig, because regardless of how nappy it is or the quality of the hair, when you sign up for a job, you feel me, you don't want to mess up nobody's unit, you feel me? So you got to be real gentle, real patient, real careful, because honestly, it's possible for you to rip out a whole patch of hair from the lace if you're brushing too hard, and you know, that ain't good. And you don't want the hair to be thin, so you know, you want to take your time. A lot of hair did come out in the end, but hey, better than nothing. And you feel me? So I went ahead and started making the watercolor dye. I just put some hot water and the dye, but I was testing it, making sure that it wasn't the wrong color by putting a little end in. So I put the got to be spray on the lace, so you feel me, it ain't getting dyed with nothing else. Put some more dye in there and went ahead and dunked that wig on in that bitch, because it's not enough time to keep on playing like that. So I went ahead and submerged it inside of that pot of water and dye. And I was already suspecting, like, it's going to get lighter once I wash it. Once I condition it and yada, yada, yada. So I'm looking, I'm like, you feel me? It's looking okay. You feel me? It's looking like I done did what I was supposed to did and done what I was supposed to done. So after that, you feel, y'all don't even know how to dye hair like me. Okay, so boom. I just went ahead and started combing it out. Told y'all she ain't had no blow dryer, so boom. Motherfucker wanted to go get the blow dryer when our people's headed next door. I'm like, we could have had the blow dryer whole too many times, so it's all cool. So I'm blow drying and I'm like, let me get her ass back in the motherfucking chair. Get her back in the motherfucking chair. But some mo got to be glue spray on that shit because the cap wasn't sticking at all. I think all that gel was really just making it sticky. So I did that, got it reeled down, and made it look like scalp up close to me. I don't know about y'all. Put the lace glue on there because I knew it was going to take some time for all the layers to dry. And Nyla, she stayed getting up. Like, she stayed just doing something. So I'm like, I know that was going to be the case. So you feel me? I just got him put, like, 2 good layers on there so it could get It could get good, you feel me? And once it was time to come, you see, she put that jacket on. That means she left. She came back. She did a lot. She put her whole hood over the glue. It was all that. But I'm gonna get it right. So I'm gonna start going from ear to ear, applying the lace to her forehead. Man, tell me why she wanted it closer down to her forehead. And I'm like, that's understandable. But she was talking about she wanted it close by her eyebrow. And I'm like, listen, I'm not gonna put my name on that. You feel me? I ain't gonna put my name on that. So boom, we get it right. You feel me? We get it to the right spot. I'm like, let me get it right. So right then and there, I'm like, that's before any melt. That's before anything. It's like I just cut the lace straight off. Boom, boom, boom. No hot comb. So we going around that bitch with a flat iron. One thing about me, I'ma always make some work. I done did hair with less than 5 materials before. But look, go around the head getting it right. Now I know she wanted a half up, half down, a different style. But during the circumstances, I couldn't do that for her. So boom, we just gonna get it straight for real, for real. So she wanted a side part. You know, a big part of me the other day was like, you know what, I ain't gonna do no edges on this side. But then I'm like, that's shiesty for real. So right here, I'm like, do you like it? She like,
yeah.
But do you?
I don't see the lace. You see it? Like, is it sticking up?
I don't see no lace.
And her friend like, I don't see no lace. And I'm like, yo. When they get the geeky, when they get the running like that, you know you did what you were supposed to do.
Drake has accomplished another mission.
This was a Quapa makeup in the lane. He likes it, so I love it. So thank y'all for watching. Period.
I stir the face. You a fuck a rich nigga for the fame, won't you? You'll get that pussy